A black mom was traveling on a plane with her son. She noticed an elderly veteran who was uncomfortable in his seat. Out of the kindness of her heart, she swapped seats with him, and something unbelievable happened. "Mom, I'm starving," little Ed cried, as he munched his biscuit. His small face was etched with worry and anger. The boy was just 6 years old. His eyes were teary, and he forced himself to eat the biscuit. He had been feeding on snacks and very light meals for the past 5 days. His mom, Evelyn, couldn't do much other than watch with sadness. She was broke and couldn't afford any decent meals at the moment. As the boy kept crying out in protest, she carried him and whispered sweet words of encouragement to him. "Everything will be okay," she comforted the boy, but the little lad was too starved to listen to her soothing words. For every reassuring word from Evelyn, it was met with loud cries of anger and frustration. "We have a flight to catch in a few hours. Once we settle into the new city, I'll make your favorite meal," she teased the boy's cheeks. Those words seemed to calm baby Ed down, and Evelyn seized the opportunity to pack a few things. If she wasted any more time, they might miss their flight. 10 minutes later, they were outside, and Evelyn flagged down a taxi. They carefully got in, and she rocked Ed to sleep as he was getting dizzy. During the drive, Evelyn reminisced about the short and blissful marriage she had once enjoyed. However, Ed's sharp cries soon snapped her out of her thoughts. He kept whining and crying, complaining about hunger. Unfortunately, Evelyn was on a very tight budget and worried if the money she had would be enough. She was relocating to a new city and needed cash for accommodation and other necessities. As the boy's tears continued, she pulled out a jar of cookies and fed them to him. Ed munched the snacks but kept whining about wanting a big bowl of fried turkey and a rich cup of ice cream. Evelyn still kept on with the promise of preparing the meal for him when they arrived. She knew that wasn't going to happen unless she got a new job, but she had to do anything to soothe her son. 40 minutes later, she arrived at the airport and completed her clearance. She was issued a seat number and she headed into the plane with a sense of fear. She kept wondering what life was going to be like in a strange city. She hadn't worked for a better part of her life, so there was a lingering feeling of anxiety. Ed's sharp cry came up again, and she grimaced in frustration. The little boy was almost a thorn in the flesh. She rested him on her seat and started to sing a lullaby for him. The song was Ed's favorite, and soon he fell asleep. As the boy started snoring lightly, her mind flashed back to the good times she had had. Evelyn was married to Derek, a loving and devoted U.S. Army officer who adored her deeply. He ensured that she lived a comfortable life, providing her with everything she needed, from luxurious clothes to extravagant jewelry. Although Evelyn expressed a desire to work and build a career, Derek insisted that he make enough money to support them both. When Evelyn became pregnant 9 months into their marriage, Derek was overjoyed. He eagerly anticipated the arrival of their baby and lavished their unborn child with expensive toys, clothes, and accessories. He spent hours browsing through baby stores, selecting the finest items for their little one. However, Derek had a spending problem. He spent his entire paycheck on luxury items, groceries, and gifts for Evelyn and their baby. He would often come home with surprise presents, expensive gadgets, and high-end clothing. He also had a gambling addiction. He didn't gamble out of necessity, but rather in hopes of winning big to fulfill his dreams of luxury: a private jet, an expensive house on a private island, and a fleet of Rolls-Royce Phantoms. Every evening, Derek would spend hours at the casino, losing most of his earnings on games of chance. He would try his luck at the slot machines, blackjack tables, and roulette wheel, always hoping to hit the jackpot. Despite his losses, Derek continued to gamble, convinced that the next big win was just around the corner. As a result, he often ran out of money weeks before payday, and Evelyn would use her saved cash to help him cover their living expenses. Despite his flaws, Evelyn loved Derek deeply, and he adored her just the same. One evening, Derek was at the casino with a few friends. He gambled and drank heavily, becoming extremely intoxicated. After spending hours there, he decided to drive home. The alcohol in his system made him overly excited, and he kept pressing harder on the gas pedal. It was late, and his car was the only one in the express lane. Driving at a very high speed, he failed to notice an object in the middle of the road. In an attempt to dodge it, he swerved and crashed into a pole. The impact was severe, and the airbags couldn't save him. He slumped over the steering wheel and, sadly, lost his life on the spot. Evelyn's world shattered when she received the devastating news. She felt as though a darkness was consuming her and swallowing her whole. The shock sent her into a state of unconsciousness. Her body went limp and her mind went blank. She was rushed to the hospital, where doctors and nurses scrambled to save her life. After intense treatment, they finally stabilized her condition. But just as she began to recover, her water suddenly broke and she went into labor. Despite the turmoil, she gave birth to a beautiful baby boy. As she held her newborn in her arms, Evelyn's heart ached with a mix of joy and unbearable pain. The thought of raising her child without Derek by her side was a daunting reality. After returning home from the hospital, Evelyn faced the agonizing task of planning Derek's funeral. The funeral was her breaking point. As she watched her husband being lowered to the ground, she screamed and wanted to join him. No one had ever loved her as he did, and his departure left a huge void in her heart. Sympathizers had to intervene to stop her from hurting herself, reminding her that she had a son to live for. After the funeral, her husband's creditors came knocking. It was a traumatic experience for Evelyn to watch her husband's cars get taken away. Derek had gambled himself into debt and planned to sell some properties to pay off the bills, but he died before he could do so. The casino's bookers kept calling, threatening to take the house she lived in. Evelyn had to beg them for more time to sort things out. The military provided Evelyn with a compensation payment, but she was unable to use the money effectively. Most of it went towards paying off her husband's loans and debts. Things got so bad that she even struggled to afford her son's basic needs. After selling a few properties, Evelyn decided to start a business. However, the relentless debts kept piling up, and she spent over 6 years trying to manage loans with ever-increasing interest rates. She reported the situation to the military, but they couldn't offer much help. The military had already given her compensation and had little sympathy for gambling issues. Realizing she couldn't continue managing the mounting debts and gambling losses, Evelyn decided she needed to leave the city. The financial strain was overwhelming and draining her. With the little money she had managed to save, Evelyn booked a flight to another city, hoping for a fresh start. It was a tough decision, as her funds were nearly depleted, but she prioritized her sanity and peace of mind. Evelyn was still deep in thought when she noticed an elderly man, Paul, limping towards her. As she looked at him, she noticed that he was wearing a military cap, and her eyes widened as she recognized the insignia of a 5-star general. The cap was a distinctive symbol of the highest rank in the military, and she couldn't help but feel a sense of respect. She watched him slowly lower himself into a seat in front of her. Evelyn noticed that the old man seemed uncomfortable in his seat, unable to stretch his numb legs. He appeared restless, so she decided to help. She invited him to sit beside her and then gently moved her sleeping son to a vacant seat on her left. The old man saw the large space in the new seat where he could stretch out and smiled gratefully at Evelyn. Slowly, he lifted himself to take the new seat. Just 2 minutes later, the man slipped Evelyn a note and flashed a smile. Evelyn accepted it and simply kept it in her bag. Afterward, her mind drifted into deep thoughts again, but her son's cries brought her back to reality. The boy was complaining about hunger, so she rocked him gently and told him to be quiet. She got a snack from the air hostess and fed him. The boy's cries diverted the old veteran, who inquired about the circumstance. Evelyn, not wanting to burden him, simply said the boy was fine. However, the veteran could see that the boy was hungry, and that Evelyn seemed troubled. He had noticed her lost in thought and wondered what the problem might be, but he chose not to intrude. As the plane took off, the veteran pulled out a photo album and began flipping through it. The images Evelyn saw aroused her curiosity. She admired the images, and the old man noticed her interest. With a smile, he started sharing stories about each photo. Veteran Paul, who had served in the Army for over 50 years and was nearing retirement, had fought in more than 25 civil wars across America and Europe. He had taken pictures in every country he visited. As he narrated the stories behind the photos, he became emotional, shedding tears over the pages that showed his fallen friends. Evelyn's worries faded as she listened to the veteran's story. He recounted his last battle in Russia, a fierce fight where he nearly lost his life if not for the bravery of a few men. When he turned to the next page, Evelyn froze. There was a photo of her husband, Derek, smiling as he stood beside the veteran. Tears welled up in her eyes as memories of Derek surfaced. He had often shared stories about his life in the Army. Noticing her emotional reaction, the veteran asked what was wrong. "This man is my husband," she trembled. The veteran was surprised. Derek was among the men he had trained 9 years ago for a mission. Although he hadn't known Derek personally, he remembered him as kind, obedient, and skilled. Evelyn informed him that Derek had died in a car accident. The veteran offered her condolences and asked why she was troubled. Reluctant to burden him with her problems, Evelyn shared a bit about her situation and why she was traveling, but she left out some details. The veteran simply sympathized with her and wished her luck. He thanked her for swapping seats with him, then closed his album and settled back in his chair to sleep. Evelyn was left to her thoughts, feeling some relief that Ed was asleep. At least now, she has a bit of time to herself. 40 minutes later, as the plane prepared to land, the turbulence jolted Ed awake, causing him to cry again. As passengers began to disembark, the old veteran bid Evelyn goodbye and reminded her to check the note. Evelyn was stunned and wanted to read the note immediately, but her son needed to use the restroom. After taking care of him, she retrieved the note from her purse and read it. It contained a few scribbled numbers, and she wondered what they meant. "Perhaps it is a security code," she muttered to herself. Evelyn led her son off the plane and headed to a hotel where she could rest and plan her next steps. On the way, she showed the note to a few people, who explained that it contained a street and house number. It then occurred to her that the veteran wanted her to visit him. Once she arrived at the hotel, she ordered the cheapest food for herself and her son. Afterward, she checked the veteran's note again and realized it contained a street and house number. It then occurred to her that the veteran wanted her to visit him. The next day, Evelyn decided to visit the veteran. Although she struggled to find the street, a few helpful locals directed her. When she arrived at the house and confirmed the address, she knocked on the door. The veteran opened it, greeted her with a warm smile, and welcomed her inside. After she settled into the spacious house, the old man cleared his throat and thanked her for her kindness on the plane. Then, with a smile that seemed to light up the entire room, he offered her a job as his chef and house manager, with a salary that took her breath away. Evelyn's heart swelled with joy, and her eyes welled up with happy tears. She had lost hope, feeling like she was drowning in a sea of uncertainty. But this miracle arrived just in time. The veteran's generosity didn't stop there. He offered her a free place to stay, a cozy little cottage on his property, complete with a garden full of vibrant flowers and a porch that seemed to whisper sweet nothings in the breeze. He also asked her to start the next day. Tears of happiness pricked at her eyes as she accepted, feeling like she'd finally found a home. The veteran's warmth and kindness enveloped her, making her feel seen and loved, like a precious gem that had finally found its rightful setting. The next day, Evelyn and Ed moved into their apartment. As she settled into her role, she observed that the veteran had no family. Apart from his doctor, she had never seen anyone visit him. Veteran Paul had a deep passion for the military. Born into a family with a military background, he attended military school throughout his life. Afterward, he requested a transfer and moved to Slovenia to serve with NATO forces. His extensive travels made it hard for him to settle down. He never spent more than 9 months in any one country, making it impossible to start a relationship. By the time he settled in America at age 50, he was too old to begin a new relationship. Even if he had wanted to, his demanding schedule, including a major operation to command, left him with no time for personal matters. Unfortunately, the operation turned out to be his last. During one of the NATO wars, he found himself in enemy territory when a bomb exploded, sending shrapnel into his back. His men rescued him and rushed him to the hospital. After several surgical operations, he recovered but was advised to stay off the field. This forced him into retirement and he had to return to his home country. As Evelyn continued with her duties, the veteran grew very fond of her. He loved her cooking, which was a delightful change since he hadn't had good American food in years. He also formed a strong bond with her son, Ed. The veteran taught Ed some military skills and gave him military regalia as a birthday gift. After a few months, the veteran sadly fell ill and was in severe pain, unable to walk. That evening, Evelyn called an ambulance, and he was rushed to the hospital. He was diagnosed with arthritis and was informed that he would need a wheelchair for the rest of his life. Once he returned home, Evelyn made sure to ease his discomfort as much as possible. She took great care of him, and the old man felt grateful for having met her. Every morning, Evelyn would wheel the veteran out for a walk in the park and then to the beach. The veteran enjoyed the beach view in the morning. It was therapeutic for him. Despite his pain, the veteran felt comforted because Evelyn was always there for him. Ed, too, took care of the veteran to the best of his abilities. He would run small errands around the house. The bond between the veteran and Ed grew strong, resembling a father-son relationship. Ed even expressed his desire to join the military, and the veteran promised to recommend him. In a few weeks, the veteran was about to turn 99, and he wanted to celebrate this milestone. Evelyn took charge of the preparations, hiring an event planner to handle the details. The day of the celebration arrived, and many high-ranking military personnel were invited and attended. During the event, Veteran Paul expressed his gratitude to the U.S. Army for allowing him to serve the country. In his speech, he thanked Evelyn and her son for coming into his life when he needed a family the most. He joked that without Evelyn's motherly care, he might have passed away by now. Though the attendees took it as a lighthearted comment, the veteran was sincere. He also announced that Ed was his godson and should be treated with love and respect when he joined the academy. The celebration featured plenty of food and drinks, and as the night went on, guests gradually went home. Late into the night, something tragic happened. The veteran began groaning in his sickbed as he struggled to breathe. He knew his time on Earth was coming to an end. He called Evelyn and her son to his side. With a satisfied smile, he took his last breath. For Evelyn, this was another devastating loss. She had lost a man who was like a father to her. After calling the ambulance, she cried deeply as his body was carried away. She then began making plans to move out, having saved enough to start her own business. However, fate had other plans for her. After the veteran's funeral, a tall man in a dark suit approached Evelyn and introduced himself as the veteran's attorney. He scheduled an appointment with her and visited the next day. Evelyn was uncertain about his purpose, but the attorney reassured her that everything was in order. He then pulled out several documents from his suitcase. These were the veteran's will. To her shock, the will revealed that all the veteran's estates and businesses were bequeathed to Evelyn and her son. After completing the necessary paperwork and signing the documents, Evelyn was officially in charge. It all came about because she had offered the veteran a comfortable seat on the plane. What do you think about the veteran's decision? Thank you for watching. See you in the next video.